students. Welcome to today's lesson. My name is Iram Khatra. I'm working at Ehlanzeni College under a program Information Technology and Computer Science, lecturing systems analysis and designs. So today we're going to look at a lesson in the subject System Analysis and Design, NCV Level 4. So we are going to look at today's topic, which is information gathering techniques, but focusing mainly on the module interviews, mainly on interviews. So we're going to look at the definition. Why do we gather data first? Why do we have to do interviews? Then we look at new systems being developed in all industries around us. So as a system analyst, you are hired to design a new system, or you are hired to improve an existing system. So that is why we look at the reasons why we gather data, new system being developed in that company, upgrading the existing system, or you implement a new system. Now you are hired that there is a new system that needs to be implemented. But as a system analyst, you have the power to do your own investigation, which is now is then that you have to do data gathering so that you can implement a new system with better information and understanding of what the system is doing in that company. So moving forward, what is an interview? Remember, today's lesson is all about an interview. What is an interview? So an interview, it's a formal meeting where two people are meeting one-on-one. Then there is a person who will be asking the questions and the other one will be answering a question. When you look at the cartoon picture there, it says that it's a formal meeting. If you can check, that is a setup of an office. That is why these people are meeting together. What is the goal of this meeting? Is to gather relevant information about the system that we are going to design or the one that we are going to improve. That's a definition of an interview. Remember, it is very important to mention the keywords. It has to be a formal one-on-one with a better purpose. So now, remember, there is a person who's supposed to ask the question and a person who's supposed to answer the question. Who's that person? We have what is an interviewer and what is an interviewee. An interviewer has to ask the questions because you are the interviewer as a system analyst. Okay? Then we have an interviewee. Those are the candidates that you'll be asking questions to. That's an interviewee. The person supposed to answer all the questions that you'll be giving out. Okay? Now we look at the purpose of an interview. Remember, you are going to gather information. But what is it that specifically that you are looking for? We are going to be looking for useful information in that company. That is why it says that it's useful for gathering detailed information. You are not going to write everything that the interviewee is going to say, but you are going to be specific based on the purpose of the interview to gather information in order to build a new system or to gather information in order to improve a new system. You have to be specific as you ask your questions. So now, we look at the types of information that you are going to gather. Remember, this interview is going to be done in a setup that is formal, specifically in that company. So we are going to look at what is it that they are doing. The first question is what? So now, when you call all upon your interviewees, it's important to tell them what is the purpose of your interview. So that when you ask the question, what is it that the company is doing? We'll take an example of a banking environment. If you're going to interview a cashier, you'll ask them, what is it that you are doing? Do you take money cash? Or do you usually work on systems? How do you encourage your customers to deposit? What is exactly your duty as a cashier? That is the what part. Then you come to the how. How are you doing all the processes in your company? So what you're going to focus much on how, as an interviewer, you need to focus on this part because this is part of your system. This is what you're actually here for, the main purpose of the company. So as a cashier will explain that, a client will come to me, then with money, if it's too much, we rearrange the case, the person to the next cashier who is responsible for more or Maybe let's take more sums that has to be used. So now as the person explains the how part, you are taking your notes because you need to make sure that there are things that need to be improved. If you miss some of the things about the system, you will have a problem. Why? Because now you'll find that that is the problem about the existing system. So on the how part during information gathering, it's the time that you have to spend more of your focus. Okay, then we come to why. Every business, remember when we're still doing level 3, we look at the business processes and we're focusing much on profit. Now, as a business, we are going to focus on building a system. You are here to help the people. Why are you doing this? Why are you upgrading from the existing system to a new one? Then the person will explain that maybe we cannot handle cash too much. That is why we are taking this to the new technology. Or, as you can remember, we are now living in a fourth industrial revolution, which is the fourth 4IR. So they want to move with the technology that we are moving in. As a system analyst, remember, you have the qualities of designing systems as a programmer. So now you will know that they have to do these changes. So these are the things that you are looking at when you are saying why. Okay? So I hope you have understand that what is it that exactly you are there for. You have to keep in mind as an interviewer that you don't lose focus, you record everything and make sure that everything is noted down, especially the important aspects. Now, focusing on the pros and cons. Everything that we have has its advantages and of course its disadvantages. So that is why I use the word pros and cons. We are going to focus on the first one, which is the pros, the goodness of an interview. Why do you take an interview as one of your data gathering tool? Remember, we have all different techniques. We do have a questionnaire, we do have all these things that we can use like observations and so on. But immediately when you choose an interview, you must be having the advantages more to your data gathering. So we are going to look at the relationship. As an interviewer, which is a system analyst, you are not here to interview for job purposes. You are here to gather information. So you need to build relationships with the users. You need to build a relationship with the people in that company. So when you do the one-on-one interviews, is then that you're going to build a strong relationship. We come to the next one, a body language interpretation. You will know when someone is nervous and not giving correct answers, so that you'll calm that person and assist to give right answers. That is why a body language interpretation is very important. We focus on rich, detailed facts. Remember, we are looking at the pros. What is it that is benefiting you as an interviewer? So when you ask a person a question and you find that you didn't receive all the relevant information you are looking for, the detailed part, you have the right to continue and prompt that person further question. For example, clarify me, what do you mean that now we have to deposit money outside an ATM? Because here is an old person coming to your company, who wants to deposit money. Now you tell that person to take that cash outside the ATM. And you know when you're dealing with older people, they don't understand that a machine can take my money. Now you have to understand and you're going to detail everything down, which is one of the things that why do we move to the new systems, okay? But as I said, everything has its goodness, but of course, we do have the disadvantages. Now we are going to look at the cons of an interview. Limited respondent. Remember, you have to go to a center and pick your own respondents. You cannot take the whole company. Since you're not working in that company, you won't know everyone who's having more information, who's having less. That is why it is a disadvantage, because you will pick people that won't give you detailed information. Number two, it is expensive. I'm just going to take you back a little bit to a topic where we talk about the success of a system. So when it comes to the success of a system, it has to be delivered on time. So when we're saying that Interviews are expensive. You are going to do one-on-one interviews. You'll take time to interview the first person, going to the next person who is the manager, going to the next person who's maybe the cleaner. And now, the more time you spend, is the more that your system is going to be expensive. Why are we saying it's expensive? Remember, the success of a system depends on time. The more time you spend, the more money you'll be using traveling around. That is why it is expensive. Okay, the third part is time consuming. I've already mentioned that you'll have to come in and out, interview each person, giving other people a break. Those who are nervous, you have to calm them down and wait for them and continue to ask them questions again. So, students, you have to be able to understand each pros and each cons and be able to explain, as I was giving the explanation, why is it expensive? Why is it time consuming? So most of the questions will ask you, explain the advantages. It won't say just name the advantages. You must be able to name and explain, which shows understanding of what you're talking about. Okay? Now we look at preparing for interviews. You know that in every successful interview, there must be preparation around. So we are going to look at what are the guidelines. What is it that is going to guide you that I am doing the right thing? I am going to present my interview successfully. We look at the environment. If you can check, I've just bring out a cartoon with a woman on a wheelchair. So when you go to a company, you find that they're using stairs. You cannot choose an upper floor environment for a person to interview while you know that person is using a wheelchair. So we choose a suitable environment to do our interviews. As a system analyst, you must keep in mind that. Then you choose the right people. Irrespective of gender, race, you do not choose people according to their gender. Why? Because you will find that the company, it's possible if the company give you that person, because you'll find that in a certain department, there are only males. But you need to note as a system analyst, topic one, we deal with ethnicity. We need to look at why did they have to have males? Were there no females around to hire them? So you know that. Why? Because at the end, you'll have to write a report. You'll tell them that, no, this company, there's something wrong with gender equality. It's something that you have noted. Okay, plan the interview. You have to bring everything down. You write, what is it that I'm looking for? Main thing in planning is the purpose of the interview. Am I upgrading or not? Am I including a new system? Is there anything that I have to build out or not? Remain neutral, which I believe students one day will go to an interview where you'll find that actually this person is posing serious questions and I cannot answer them, but I do want the job. So you have to be neutral as an interviewer, which is a system analyst. You do not prompt the user to answer more just by your actions. Be neutral always. Listen carefully and take notes. You are there to gather information. Remember, you have to take all the notes as the person is answering the question, but bearing in mind the important information. What is it that I'm here for? Remember, the purpose always shall prevail. Then you'll have to review your notes and report. You write a report. This is the information that I've gathered. This is what I was looking for. These are the things that I was not looking for, because you are not just gathering information. There is a system to be built. There is a system to be improved. Okay? So, with the things that I've just said, remember, we're looking at the guidelines of an interview, which is very important as an analyst. We have a possible question. So I just want you to alert you as level 4 student. System analysis and design is a theoretical subject. Most cases, they'll bring out a scenario from the first question until to the last question. You have to understand the scenario so that you can pick what's important and be able to answer the questions. We are looking at one of them. I'll read it out so that you understand it. And we have to look at the keywords. It says that you have been given the task of investigating how the registration system on a Tshwane TVET college can be improved. Note, you are improving a system. You are not building a new system. Learners are tired of long queues during registration, which I know is frustrating. You have to find out how the current system actually operates, how you think you can improve or change the current system. The school is considering a new system that will speed up the registration process. There is a system in place, but it doesn't work for the college and the students. Now, as a system analyst, you are hired to come and gather information so that we can build a new system, improving the current one. Remember, a system is not always something that has to be computerized. To queue and register, it's a system itself, because you have to get a brochure, you have to select a course, you have to write a selection test, all those processes, they form a system. Remember, we've done that already in level 3. Keep in mind, now we have to collect data. So they said we have been asked to develop a plan for fact finding, a plan, and have decided to interview learners and the administration staff on their experiences. We have this scenario. Now, as a student, we have underlined or tick what are the keywords and what is it that you're actually looking for. So what is the question? List 4 factors or guidelines you will keep in mind when conducting the interview with the students. I've made an example about banking environment. You don't have to bring bank back again. Now you are in a college. You have to keep in mind, what is it that I have to do? What is it that I have to collect? Why are we including administration staff? Remember, when you are registering as a student, you need to be assisted by the admin staff. So I've brought out possible examination answers. So we are going to look at each one of them. They say the format or the type of interview. Now, whether it's a one-on-one or we are going to take a panel, maybe 3 or 4 students. But remember, when you choose the format of the interview, students can always disturb you there and there because they can answer at the same time. So we said an interview, it's a formal one-on-one. In order to control the environment, you need to think about who are you going to interview. Now we come to the environment or the place. You cannot take students to interview them in a cafeteria. They may order, or they may tell you that they are hungry, whatever that they are thinking of. So now you have to think about a proper environment. It can be a boardroom where you can collect your information better. The manner in which you will behave towards the students. Remember, we talk about that you must make sure that the person is comfortable. Do not interrupt the person. Make them comfortable, introduce yourself, give them what you're going to do, what is the information that you're looking for, so that the person can relax and be comfortable, then you may start with the interview. The language used when interviewing the students. Okay? I'll take an example. I speak Siswati. I cannot go to a college where there are Sotho people and start prompting questions in Siswati. I have to use a relevant language, which is English. You can all understand English. So I cannot say that since they are students, maybe they will answer me better in their language, which I don't understand. Now we are looking at Sesotho. So it's best to maintain a better language, which will bring out all the information. But should it happen that they are not comfortable with your language or English, you can get someone to interpret. What you are doing there is gathering information. You are not in a class to look who's speaking English or not. If a person can give out useful information, and of course, we are in a TVET college. We do take people from home who maybe they last, I don't know when last they went to school. They are here for the NCV subject. So you might find someone that, how is the system? How do you understand the registration system? And the person will start answering Sesotho. You need an interpreter because it's not about the language, it's about gathering the information. Okay? So that's how we attempt questions when you are given. You are an analyst. Whatever that you do, you have to analyze. Okay, we look at an interview checklist. What is it that I must do when I'm going to conduct an interview before? So you cannot just come in and say, okay, good morning everyone, I'm here to conduct an interview, let's start. No, you have to plan. Before, you must look at the venue. Is it suitable for all the candidates? You must select all the people that you're going to interview. You must plan your questions. Remember to include the purpose of the interview. That's the before. We're coming to juring. You have your candidate in front of you. You have to interview this person. Make sure that you introduce yourself as an analyst, introduce the topic that you want to do the interview about, and make sure that the people understand the purpose of the interview. Calm the person. Calm the person. You can see the cartoon. That person is so scared. And we are not even sure why this person is so scared. Maybe the voice was like, I need all the information and I have to build a better system. And the person is like, okay. So calm that person. The candidate has to be happy that I'm assisting this person to get information. Be calm, be consistent, make sure that your interview enjoys the interview. That's the jury. Now we come to after. We are done with the interview. The person is still standing in front of you. You need to thank the interviewee. You need to write the notes. You need to make sure that all the information that you have gathered are noted down. Okay? Types of questions of an interview. You cannot just go inside the interview and say, okay, good day. What is it that you're doing in this company? And the people will be like, okay, is there order in these questions? We are going to look at open-ended questions. What is an open-ended? Open-ended. It means when you prompt a person that question, there might be a follow-up to that question. We look at specific keywords. Please, note this part of the question. What? It starts with what. It's a keyword. What are you doing in your business? You cannot say, just say, we are selling sweets. Okay? Why did you choose to sell sweets? You are prompting, you want to understand better. Those are the open-ended questions. Coming the why. How? Do you manufacture your own sweets? Do you stock or whatever that you're doing? So these are open-ended questions and they are more detailed. You'll get more information using an open-ended question. We have a closed-ended questions. With closed-ended questions, is then that will ask a simple question and expecting the person to give you a straightforward answer. Who is the manager of this company? Who is the person responsible for everything that you are doing? Who runs the system? Who registers the students? So those are short questions. Where can I find a person who's going to help me with the current system? When do you register people? I'll take back the example of a banking company where we are saying when do we experience more customers? We cannot say the beginning of the month. Yeah, it's possible because we do have a social grant. Or month end, the 15 dates, and so on. So those questions are going to give you straightforward answers, but still, you have to bear in mind one thing. You are here to collect information. Everything about an interview, you need to make sure that you keep the purpose in mind. As a system analyst, make sure that everything done is recorded so that you can review and report back to the people who hired you. So, okay, based on the lesson that I've just presented, if you need further clarification or any questions that you need me to address or to assist you on this lesson, you can contact us on the college website, which is www.ehlanzenicollege.co.za. We have our social platform, Facebook, Twitter. Then we'll respond from there. Thank you. So the lesson was brought by me, which is I'm Kaja for Aira. And stay home, stay safe. Thank you.